بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي أما بعد السلام عليكم
السلام
بارك الله فيكم for tuning in for the third episode of Only If You Knew Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. I'd like to welcome all of our dear viewers. Thank you very much for basically sacrificing the most important thing in your life besides your religion, which is time. The most valuable thing in the world. So I thank you for trusting me with those few minutes, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of us for learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beautiful names. Just to introduce our two new guests, go ahead.
Adis
and?
Rai.
And Rai, and again, Ahmed and Omar. Barakallah fikum. Tayyib. Today's, we're going to start with the names. Are you guys excited? I'm very, very excited. This name is one of the dearest names to me. This name is needed for every parent that is worried about their children from having bad friends, for having a horrible future, for not succeeding in this dunya or akhirah. They're very worried. This is the name you're looking for. For every student that is worried for their exams, for their future, for the job, for the career, for a spouse that they want to get married, this is the name you're looking for. For everyone who wants to do something for Islam and you're like, I need to do something for Islam, and you're just back and forth and hesitant, this is the name you're looking for. If you have any goal, any dream, anything that you wish to accomplish in your life, wallahi, this is the name you're looking for. It's Allah's beautiful name. Huh? Al-Wakil. Al-Wakil. The ultimate trustee. What does Allah Al-Wakil mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Al-Wakil is the one who took care of His creation by managing and bringing them into existence and guiding them and providing for them. So He's in control, Al-Wakil, the ultimate trustee. So He is the one who takes care of your matters with perfection. So He does not get you lost, and He does not disappoint you, and He does not entrust your case, no matter how small it is, to anyone else. So if you put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Wakil, He does not assign someone else to take care of you because your case is so small. For example, we have in the States, in North America, there's a lawyer that has a lot of commercials. His number is 1-800-CALL-SAM. So you're going to call a lawyer, that's Sam. Everywhere, and he's known to be a very, very big lawyer. But the thing is, when you call that lawyer and you discuss your case to them, had your case not have so much money into it, Sam will not help you. Sam will get another lawyer who's younger than him or smaller to take care of your case. Allah is the best of examples. No matter how small it is that you need to push for, you want to put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will take care of it. And when Allah Al-Wakil comes and you do believe in that name of Allah and you truly knew Him, and only if you knew Him, you will be called what? When you put your trust in Allah, you will have a title. And it is one of the Prophet ﷺ's names. And it is?
Mu'min.
Al-Mutawakkil, excellent. So good job. Al-Mu'min or Al-Mutawakkil? Al-Mutawakkil, the one who placed their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does Al-Mutawakkil mean? And may Allah make us amongst the Mutawakkilin. And you know why I began with this one right here? The first name. So as we get to know Allah more and more, that putting in His trust in Allah becomes easier on us because we get to know Allah more and more. Al-Mutawakkil is the one who takes every possible mean to accomplish their goal. And once they finish everything they can do, they what? حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah, I put my trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never stop. Again, never stop. Alayhi wa sallam. Whether you're recording, whether you're playing with the lights, alayhi wa sallam, no matter what you're doing, صح? He was the Sayyid al-Mutawakkilin, the best of Mutawakkilin. When he would take the means, he will not be scared from anyone. One time he went and rested under a tree, and he was around the Sahaba. They were around, maybe a little distance. And then he hung his sword on a tree branch. So he took the means and he took a nap. He's not expecting anyone to come over and do anything to him. All of a sudden, a person from the kuffar comes, grabs the sword, and puts it on the neck of Rasulullah ﷺ. And the Prophet wakes up. And he tells him, من يمنعك مني? Who's going to stop you from me now? Al-Mutawakkil, his heart is connected to Allah. So you know what the Prophet said? Allah! So the sword dropped. Then the Prophet grabbed the sword, put it on his neck. He said, وَمَن يَمْنَعُكَ مِنِّي? And who will stop you from me? He said, Kun khayra akhid, come on, be gentle. I didn't do anything to you. I only put the sword on you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Atashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah? Would you testify that there's no deity worthy of worship except Allah and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a slave and messenger? What did he say? He said, no. The Prophet said, okay, go ahead. Subhanallah. Sayyidul Mutawakkilin. He doesn't force people to Islam. La ikraha fi din. We don't force you to become Muslims. No. The Prophet is teaching him it's Allah al-Wakil who takes care of the believers when they put their ultimate trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you mind if I give you an example to understand more what does it mean to put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Very important example. If you were to ever go to a lawyer and you would seek power of attorney, what does it mean? You go to a lawyer and let's say you're traveling to another place. So you want another person who you trust to go take care of your matters by the time you're traveling. So you go to the lawyer and you tell him, you know what, I would like to give power of attorney, authority to that person that is with me to take care of my dealings. He will look at you and tell you, do you want the general power of attorney or specific? You ask them, what do you mean, general or specific? General power of attorney is that when you sign that contract, this means this man has control over everything that you have. Everything. Specific power of attorney, if you sign it, that means you've given something specific that you have control over. So a person would go and say, you know, I'm traveling, I would like to give him general power of attorney. When you say that, the man will actually, the lawyer will look at you and he says, are you sure, sir? Are you sure? He can sell your house. He can buy, he can sell your car to some other person. He can use your money in the bank. He said, yes, I trust him. I trust him. So he said, okay, here you go, sign. Where? Here, okay. I entrust and I put my trust and I give the power of attorney to such and such, the general one. I have a question for you. Are you ready to sign to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Oh Allah, take care. I entrust you with everything that I have. Are you guys ready to sign? Are you ready to sign? Bismillah. Are you ready to say, Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil? Waqa, signature. But you have to do it and don't be shaking. Do you think the guy who gave the general power of attorney to that friend, do you think he's like, I don't know. Do you think he'll be doing this? Impossible, sah? He trusts him so much. I'm giving you everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of examples. Let's sign to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and tell him, Ya wakil, tawakkalna alayk. May Allah make us amongst the mutawakkilin. Say ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was so amazing is that He is the one who is offering you to be your wakil. We might have a hard time finding a person to trust, sah? Especially these days. It's one of the signs of the day judgment. Is that you can no longer trust the people you're sitting with. Na'am. And we actually live in this time. So it's so difficult to find a person to trust everything that you have. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's offering you by many means. What can be one of the ways, or you know how Allah offers to be your ultimate trustee? Give me some, if you know any verses, any signs. And from now you would learn something that you can use in every question that I ask about how does Allah present Himself to us. Very simple. Allah named Himself Al-Wakil. Sah? He named Himself Al-Wakil. And we believe as Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, if Allah names Himself something, then the meaning applies to it. It's not, we do not distort and we don't deny. We said that earlier, right? Allah Al-Wakil. By naming Himself Al-Wakil, He's telling you, put your trust in me. And you will know in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He offers you His trust, He shows you His power and might. To tell you, don't worry, put your trust in me. I have the power, I have the knowledge, I have the experience. Don't hesitate. Look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says in the Quran, رَبُّ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ, the Lord of the East and the West. Wow, majesty. What does He say next? لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ فَاتَّخِذْهُ وَكِيلًا. There's no Lord except Him. Put your trust in Him. فَاتَّخِذْهُ وَكِيلًا. How big is your problem? Is your problem outside the East? Is your problem outside the West? No, so put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبُّ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ لَا إِلَّهَ إِلَّا هُوَ فَاتَّخِذْهُ وَكِيلًا. Look at Allah in another verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِلَّهِ غَيْبُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُرْجَعُ الْأَمْرُ كُلُّهُ. To Allah belongs and He knows the unseen and the future and everything that you don't know, where? In the heavens and on the earth. He could have said only earth, but He only adds the heavens as well. For how powerful He is, and everything returns back to Him. Everything. وَإِلَيْهِ يُرْجَعُ الْأَمْرُ كُلُّهُ. طيب الله, what He wants to do? فَعْبُدْهُ وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَيْهِ. Look at the power, the might. Are you hesitant to sign? Look how much power, look how much knowledge I have. I know everything. I know the future. I know everything, and Allah is offering you, worship Allah and put your trust. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah is not unaware of what you guys do. SubhanAllah, we go to a doctor, and you find two doctors. One doctor is an expert, and the other one is not so good. You think that people will line up to the expert or the non-expert? The expert. Even there's a long wait. We will wait for that doctor. Why? They trust in him with their bodies. SubhanAllah, a friend talking to you through a rough street at a shortcut, you trust him. So basically, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is when you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's like a shortcut for you to achieve your goals. The non-Muslims, they only depend on the means. They don't have the tawakkul part. But when you live with Allah and you know Allah, you will put your trust in him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who put our trust in Allah in everything, small and big. Say ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us aware of his might and majesty. So inshallah, with that being said, we will go for a short break inshallah. So stay tuned. And if again, I'll remind you of the last episode, read Ayatul Kursi to Allah, protect you inshallah. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say tasbih. Jazakumullah khair. I will see you shortly. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Let's make up our minds to do the right thing in this life. In our chance, Allah's name do we sing.
والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد, so we're continuing with how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-wakil is providing you his service for free, no cost, with service that is optimum to the max. He knows the unseen, he knows everything in the east, everything is in the west is under his control, and he is the one who is offering you. And we saw how Allah every time, almost not every time in the Quran, but many times when he puts Allah al-wakil, he puts what? His might and power for you not to hesitate. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ. Put your trust in the one that is all living and will never ever die, ever. SubhanAllah. You know, just before coming here to this show, I was writing my will. So had I die, where my children will go and so on. Because in Canada, if you die without writing a will, you know what happens? The government might take the children, subhanAllah, and they might take your money and so on. So you have to be very clear in the will. And when I was writing the will, it tells you two options. It says, if you die, who do you assign the children to and so on? So I put my wife. And they say, if your wife dies before you, then who do you give it to? And I was thinking, who am I going to give it to? Because I don't have much family there. So maybe I'm like my mom or my sister. Now, there's no other blanks. You know what comes to my mind? What if they both die? How? I'm worried. You write this down and you subhanAllah, you don't feel very comfortable. But Allah says, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي, I will never die. Don't sign and think I'm going to lose a paper for you. Don't think I'm going to die and no one will know about this. I'm all living. I will never ever die. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ. But make sure that when you go and you put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you want to go meet, let's say, a doctor, and you put fully your trust in Allah, don't say, oh, it's not you who helps me, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you say that, it's like, okay, is that late? Okay, get up. So it's in your heart that you maintain in your heart, that you put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then lastly, about the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah tells you that He's the creator of everything. Watch, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu khaliqu kulli shay'in wa huwa ala kulli shay'in wakil. Everything I created. So everything you're worried about, it's me who made it. So Allah is so experienced and knowledgeable. He knows everything. Don't worry. And I ask you one more time, are you ready to sign? Are you guys ready to sign? Bismillah, full trust. Oh Allah, I put full trust in you, Allah. We ask Allah to make us amongst those that never hesitate or shake our hands. And there are certain signs to know if you did sign to Allah and you are actually a mutawakkil. So the question that comes, are you guys willing to go through that gauge? And you check mark, khalas? You're going to check mark yourself. Where do I stand? Where does Rai stand? Where does Umar stand? You got to check. If you check one or two, that's a very good sign, inshallah. So let's start with a checklist of to know if you put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes or no. Number one, I'll probably mention five. Number one is when hardship comes and falls upon you, a severe one, the first thing you think about is what? Who? Allah al-Wakil. The first thing that comes in your mind. Not mama. No, not mama. Allah al-Wakil comes in your mind. Number one thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, and he praises those who think of Allah during the times of severe hardship. You know, to be honest with you, when we're relaxed and chilling and so on, we can say alhamdulillah, you know, Allah alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah for everything. But when the calamity happens, that's the true colors that appear, صح? The true you shows up. You call this, you do that. But what is Allah? Allah doesn't accept. لا, يا أخي, no, Allah al-Wakil comes first. Look at the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam, 16 years old, a young youth, mashallah, young adult. He goes and he looks at his tribe and he sees that they're what? They're worshipping idols. It upsets him. He's so jealous. He loves Allah, obedient to Allah. He doesn't want anyone to disobey Allah and so on, because the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you love a person, you don't like those who disrespect him. صح? Very logical, common sense. You love your father. If someone comes and disrespects your father, you won't like it. You don't like it. It doesn't make sense chemistry-wise to love both. صح? SubhanAllah. Ibrahim alayhi salam didn't like the idols. So he said that the moment that my tribe goes for the festival, I'm going to go and destroy all the idols. So the festival happens and Ibrahim does not go. And then he starts breaking every idol except one. Then he puts a sword over that one idol that he left. When the people came, they got so angry. They said, قَالُوا مَنْ فَعْلَ هَذَا بِآلِهَتِنَا إِنَّهُ لَمِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Who did this to our idols, to our lords? Who did that? He is surely amongst the oppressors. Then, in another few verses, they say, قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا فَتًا يَذْكُرُهُمْ يُقَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. It's perhaps Ibrahim, that little kid, Fata, subhanAllah, no respect, Fata, يُقَالَ Ibrahim. Then they say, Ibrahim, let's come and check. So Ibrahim, come, did you do this? Ask Kabirahum, ask the guy with the sword. You know, maybe he can talk. So they went back so sad and angry that you're making fun of us. And they talked to themselves and they said, he's right, we're losers, we're horrible people. But their pride and arrogance refused to accept what Ibrahim said. So they say, قَالُوا حَرِّقُوهُ, burn him. حَرِّقُوهُ is intense tahriq, not regular one. حَرِّقُوهُ and وَانْصُرُوا آلِهَتَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ فَعِلِينَ, and give victory to your lords. It's like takbir, but to their takfir part, the kufr takbir. So they all accepted. They all want to burn Ibrahim alayhi salam. And the way they want to burn him is unnormal, abnormal. Never thought, and your mind can never imagine. Look how they tried to burn him. They tried to build a structure for him and put fire in it. That structure, every single one in the city participated in burning it, making it so hot and so high. To an extent that there's some women who had their children sick, they used to make a vow to the Lord, because they do shirk. So they believe in Allah and they put idols. Is it clear? So they do shirk. They say, if my son is cured, my gift to my Lord is at participating in burning that building and making it so hot and horrible. To an extent that they had to make that building outside the city. How horrible is that? For one sin. How will Ibrahim feel? Ibrahim now is in jail, handcuffed. How are you feeling, Ibrahim? We will know very shortly. But I can tell you, and we are going to agree, that he's thinking of Allah al-Wakil. Then what they try to do is that before they want to throw, let's say this is the building, before they want to throw Ibrahim, they have to do samples and examples and tests, because they want to put Ibrahim and then shoot him and then falls here. So what they would do is that they put some wood, some khashab, etc., some like tree branches, and then test something according to the weight of Ibrahim. Look how much power, and they're trying to make the fire be. Look how much effort they're putting. This is the kuffar these days, that they hate Islam. Wallahi, they might be putting as much effort. So we need to step up the game and we need to work as hard for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No day off. The Prophet never took a day off. قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا يَا أَيُّهُ الْمُزَّمِّلِ. صح? Go, قُم. فَأَنذِرْ. Stand up and preach. And wallahi, he never stopped preaching after that verse. Never stopped. Never took a vacation. Ibrahim alayhi salam, all of that because of da'wah. Then they put the wood and then, okay, perfect size, perfect distance. Put Ibrahim. Ibrahim is placed. Then he's released. They say the fire was so hot that any bird flies over, burns. When the Ibrahim flies, in authentic hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the way there, what would a person say? The mutawakkil, only if you knew Allah al-wakil, you'll be a mutawakkil. He said, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. I put my trust in Allah al-wakil, the ultimate trustee, the one worthy of putting the trust into. And he fell in the fire. And wallahi, wallahi, wallahi. And I challenge anyone in the earth, anyone in the world, to tell me one time in their life that they took the means and they put their trust in Allah and Allah let them down. I challenge anyone on earth, because Allah named himself al-wakil. And if you put your trust in Allah, wallah al-azim, if the whole universe goes against you, no one will dare to do something Allah did not will it to happen to you. And here Allah will make it in a way that benefits you. So he said, hasbi Allah wa ni'ma al-wakil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the fire, ya naru kuni bardan wa salama ala Ibrahim. Oh fire, be cool. But Allah didn't stop here, because if he said be cool, then what will happen? He will freeze to death. But Allah said, a cool, peaceful. Bardan wa salama, cool and peaceful. So beautiful. But now if Allah stopped here, what would happen? Every fire in the house will be cool and peaceful. There's no iftar for Ramadan if there's no hot fire. Well, Allah specifies bardan wa salaman ala Ibrahim. So on in Ibrahim. So when he was tied and he was thrown in that building, what burned? The ties and the rope around him. And he spent there for some days, and then he left, and people were amazed at how he left alive. Wallahi, don't be amazed. Wallahi, we shouldn't be amazed, because Allah is al-wakil. Allah, I don't know why it's amazing. Like, people are excited. This is not adian. Allah al-wakil is so easy. He created the fire. Wallahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah told you, I created the fire so I can change the chemistry of the fire. I can make it specific cool for you. Don't worry about it. Look how Ibrahim. So the first thing he thought about was al-wakil. So this is a checklist. So brothers, sisters, brothers watching us. The first time a problem comes to you, what do you think about? Check al-wakil. May Allah make us amongst those who believe in Allah's name, al-wakil. Number two is that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cuts the means which you were depending on, your iman in al-wakil goes up. Doesn't even remain constant, rather goes up. For example, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was he depending on after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his house? Who was protecting him during the time of Mecca, hardship and so on? Who was protecting him? Who was helping out, supporting him in the house and so on? Go ahead, try. Even if it's wrong, don't worry about it. Khadija, excellent. Khadija. Who was the one helping him outside the house? And he's depending and he was helping him so much. Who is it? Go ahead, try. Don't worry, even if you make a mistake, don't worry. We all do mistakes. Go ahead, try. Abu Talib. Abu Talib, صح? The one whom, because he's from a family of Quraysh, an elite, say Abu Talib is alive, you know what? Abu Talib is alive, I can't kill Muhammad. We can't do this thing because Abu Talib is alive. His uncle is alive. صح? In the same year, Allah brings after many years of suffering, but not so much extent that the Prophet would die. What happened? Allah cuts the means of Rasulullah. Khadija dies, Abu Talib dies in the same year. And they call it Aam al-Huzn, the year of sadness. The Prophet ﷺ, the Sayyid al-Mutawakkilin, when this happens, his trust in Allah goes skyrocket. Just unbelievable. Is it clear? One more time. Rasulullah ﷺ, he goes into the cave. Khalas? He goes into the cave, he takes the means. And when he goes to runs away from Mecca to Medina, he goes down south, Medina's north. Mecca to Medina, na'am. Medina is north, so that you, common sense, he would go travel this way to immigrate. He took the means and he went south. And he tried to clean the traces by sending the shepherds and so on, and then he went to the cave. Then Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, Ya Rasulullah, they came. He said, Ya Abu Bakr, ma dhannuka bithnayni Allahu thalithahuma. The means are cut, khalas, there's nothing else they can do. What do you think of Allah? What do you think of two whom the third is who? Allah al-Wakil. Don't worry about khalas. That's it. We did everything possible. The means are cut. The iman goes up. Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises that in the Quran. Isn't that right? But the ghar for those who stayed there. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst the mutawakkilin. Wallahi, how big is your problem? How big is your problem? Is it outside the east? Is it outside the west? Would you ever face something as big as a cave of Rasulullah sallam that you have to go there or they're going to kill me? Look to that extent and they maintain their love in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam in the fire and he continued to have the trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah to make us amongst those who sign and without hesitation and continuously think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah in the next episode we will continue more of the checklists to know are we truly putting our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair for tuning up. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you and we'll see you inshallah in the next episodes continuing with Allah's beautiful name, Al-Wakil. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته